We have to say that it's difficult for us to be there with a big surprise on a weekly base. We were able to be there with a sensation against Man City, against the best teams in the world. It's not easy to surprise on a weekly base, especially not when you're still struggling with many injuries. But my feeling is also like, especially in the first half, there was a lesson we have to learn. So my feeling was in the first half we were not major and not physical enough to come close to a sensation today. My players always invest everything and show some good character, and also the second half how we handled a difficult situation was great. But in general we also have to speak about the first half, because my feeling was we were not major, not physical enough in the first half in order to be there with the next surprise. And if you are not there on a really, and everything is really top class, then you have no chance as a newly promoted side against one of the best teams in the world. Yes, that's right. Tim is great. So during the whole season, he was there with great performances, great character, great leader, his personality. For that, I'm pretty concerned because of his injury. He still overstretched his knee, and thank God he could finish the game. But we have to wait right now for the assessment tomorrow. So I hope it's not too bad. He was pretty concerned because it was his knee where he had this ACL. And I hope it's not too bad, because we can't need any more injuries. That's also for sure. But yeah, we have to wait a bit what the doctor says. I hope it's not too bad. But let's wait what the assessment brings. More or less the same for Ibrahim Amadou. He overstretched his knee and felt some pain. And it's more or less like we had to finish the game last 20 minutes more or less just with 10 lads. So it says a lot about his character that he wanted to stay on the pitch. And we were trying to hide him a bit on number 10 position, because he couldn't run anymore. And for that, he wanted to stay there, perhaps to win sometimes a header or something like this. So great character, great attitude. But of course, it was then difficult to finish the game just with 10 lads. And Jamal Lewis, he came to us at halftime and said he felt unbelievable poorly, whatever. And the doctor told me right now he has unbelievable high temperature. So not sure what happens in his body. It should be something like a virus, or at least he feels unbelievable poorly. And I had to substitute him as well. I hope it's not too long. So it seems to be like a perhaps a virus infection or illness or whatever. So I hope to have him available for next week. But the concerns are with Tim and Ibrahim at the moment. Was quite obviously that was a mistake, because the referee was wide, he didn't give a penalty, and then last anyhow two minutes with VAR to check it, and the rule is just allowed to overrule the referee's decision if there's a 100% clear and obvious mistake. And when you watch a scene back, it's quite obviously that's more a foul against my center back and instead of a foul of him. So if you want to overrule him, it's more like it should be a free kick for us given. Also, of course, not happy with the scene, because it's not good for the confidence if you concede a penalty in such a situation. But for me, it's not like I don't want to blame VAR today for our loss. So just want to speak about our behavior in the first half. There were a few things I was not happy with, and VAR was not responsible for the loss today. It was quite obviously, it was not like one of the best days and evenings of VAR this evening. But it's more a topic for some other people, not for me today. I don't blame VAR for the loss today. Yeah, in general, so we are all human beings, and we are sometimes there with mistakes. My feeling is when you want to overrule a decision of a referee, you have to be 100% sure. And perhaps we had the topic during the last week, or was that not so many penalties were given by VAR, and perhaps anyhow, I don't want to blame anyone. Perhaps you have it a bit in your mind and you think, okay, sometimes you should give a penalty. Anyhow, it was quite obviously a mistake, but listen, again, so it's more a topic for some other people. I'm a traditionalist. I like not to have too many changes in football, but I accept I'm getting older and older, and I have to accept that there are some new rules and some changes, and I take this. So in general, so of course we have to make sure that the processes are right. In general, I think my feeling in general works pretty well. So today we were not on the sunny side, and VAR was not on the sunny side. And I think in general VAR or the people and persons who are responsible for this, they are not happy today. But listen, yeah, we are all human beings and we are there with mistakes. Yeah, sometimes even if as a head coach or your player, you are there with mistakes. And I think we have to be a bit more self-critical with us instead of blaming someone today. Of course, we're not. If you have such a situation like today, you're not opening a bottle of champagne and dancing on the table as a head coach. But I take this.
Are you angry?
It's difficult to be angry with the Sleds because they always keep on going and they showed also some great character in the second half. So especially then in underload to go further on and not to concede any goal, and we reward ourselves with a good goal, and they always invest so much. But today it was also a day where you have to say, so it's sometimes as a young player you have to develop a bit and to learn some lessons, and that's the reason why not all the best teams in the world are just playing with 18-year-old lads, yeah? Because if you just have unbelievable young lads on the pitch, and it's difficult to win titles anyhow, and my young players have to learn a bit today, and for that we'll speak about this. And of course I'm not overly happy when we are there with a mistake, yeah, for example. When I think about we start pretty well into this game, and then we have the biggest chance in the game so far, out of 18 yards, brilliant assist, shooting position without any pressure. Yeah, then you have to be convinced and to be focused in order to score. And if the goalkeeper's then there was a world-class save, you have to say, okay, we take it. But I don't like it when we are just there happy just because we have a chance and not convinced and greedy to use it. And you have to do this on top level, and the same. Yeah, before the goals, first goal was not even a chance, simply cheap cross out of the half field, and we have the first touch, and we're then anyhow surprised that also opponent is in the box, and we assisted to the first goal. It was of course not major, not this behavior, but I think though, and also before the second goal, so our positioning and the counter defending was a disaster, if I'm honest. So the biggest strength of Man United at the moment is of course the pace and the counter attacks, and you have to make sure that your positioning is good and you control the counters. And our positioning was horrendous in this scene. And there are topics we have to speak about, and we have to be self-critical, and the young lads have to learn out of this. But because they always show great character and great mentality, it's difficult to be angry. But we have to be self-critical, that's for sure.
You said you thought the word physical enough in the first half, is that right? And do they need...
Yes, in general. So Tim is great during the whole season, and also in this game today he showed a lot of experience and great performance again. And for that I'm pretty, pretty concerned about his injury. So I hope to have him back, because he's one of our leaders and we definitely need him. And also we need, if I'm honest, our experienced centre-backs back, that's also for sure. Especially when you are newly promoted side, so of course I'm looking back to get a bit more experience and quality in the defense back. But as long as they are not available, we have to find some other solutions, and that's what we're trying to do at the moment.
Was it in the act of trying to save down at Martial's feet? Is